My next guest is celebrating the lives of women who are not only aging gracefully, but artfully too. Amy Gorman's book, Aging Artfully, tells of several women, some past 90, who are living with zest. Author Amy Gorman is with us now via Skype to talk about her book and about the inspiration behind it. Welcome, Amy. How are you?
Great. Thank you. Nice to be here.
Nice to see you. Let's get to why you wrote this book and what was the story behind it, because it just seems so such an interesting concept and so really very important now.
As I said in the book, I literally woke up one morning and decided to think about aging and what it was like. I was in my early 60s when I started, and I was sculpting and got stuck, as many people do when they're engaged in something that they love to do. But I said, how am I going to get past this stuck point? It could be stuck in anything.
Right.
So I started speaking to older women, really older women, and I thought a generation older. So I asked friends and people I met if they knew any artists. I wanted to limit it to artists. Not only visual artists, but anybody working in dance, in music. And the first person I met, I had no idea how old she was. She was 105 on
Wow.
this particular birthday. So it was unbelievable because she was still so alive and playing the piano every day. True, she was a miracle person. She was unusual. We're not all like that. But she got me so excited about the possibilities of living longer lives that I started meeting these amazing women and interviewed many, many of them.
So when you interviewed these women, Amy, what did you see, what did you find out was a way of linking them together? What did they do that actually helped them live such vibrant lives?
They all loved what they were doing. They had a reason to get up in the morning. And I believe that that's a critical thing, not necessarily in the arts. It could be anything. It could be your family, could be gardening, could be anything, just so long as you have a purpose and a reason to want to get going in the morning, and then your days are filled with some kind of joy.
So, as you said, not just the arts, but some sense of purpose and inspiration and also some creativity. A way to be creative is also, like you said, with your family or cooking or gardening, whatever it is.
Absolutely. Totally agree. And I think that's what pulls these women together. They all have that desire to get up and do something. And they continue to do it and they don't look back. They just move on and enjoy each moment, I think. Oh, well, they, I don't know about enjoying every moment,
sure.
But they certainly live in the moment.
Which is really important. So
really,
when you say
yeah.
not looking back, it's about not looking at the mistakes or what happened. Because you, when you and I were talking, you were also talking, Amy, about a life review. And why is that important?
This is a time in life, not necessarily waiting until 85. What I'm doing now, after I wrote the book, I started having groups pulled together to write their own life stories, because that is so psychologically healthy. When you review things you do, you realize, my goodness, I've just done so many things and I've had so many experiences, and you begin to see just how good things have been. You remember the good things more than you remember the negative things.
You know, it's interesting because oftentimes when you're not living in the moment, people remember the negative things. But when you're doing this autobiography that you're talking about, that you work with groups and you're also doing it online, as you said earlier, that it helps you remember the more positive experiences and remember what you did do that you could be really proud of. And when you go through life, now even when you're in your 40s, your 50s, your 60s, your 70s, there's so much that people do and they forget about it or they neglect to think it's something important.
That's right. Absolutely. I totally agree. I think that writing about, writing down your stories. It doesn't have to be in good English. It doesn't have to be grammatically accurate. Just getting them down for yourself and for other people who might want to read them, in your family or otherwise, your friends.
Now, when you do these groups, do the women or men, do they share the stories, or do they just keep it private? And how does it work?
In my groups, they share. It's very, very important to be able to get out and say some of tell some of the stories in your lives. We all have stories to tell. It's a great thing. Sometimes people tell stories they've never told before. Sometimes they write things that they've never written before. Some people want to keep it private. Absolutely. You can write a ton of things at home, 100 pages, and just bring two to the
right.
I think it's
very affirming when you're able to share, like you said, even just a part of it. But when you're able to share something, and other people are saying wow, or they're applauding it, and they're looking at it in such a way that makes you see the experience so much differently.
Exactly. And numerous times how people say, I never thought of it that way. I never thought I could write these down. I'm so happy I've done it. The hardest part is getting started, like with anything.
And I think it's so important what you're doing. And I think it's not only a message for people 90 and above, it's for all of us in terms of how we can stay vibrant and move forward in our aging in a very positive way. So thank you so much, Amy Gorman.
You're so welcome, and I love what you're doing. Let's keep on keeping on.
Thank you so much, you too. Stay tuned, the holidays are almost here, and instead of worrying about gaining a few extra pounds, we are going to show you how to shed some pounds with Chef Maria Loy when we return.